Hello again, everyone, and welcome to the latest edition of the Reddit 2019 Twilight Struggle League, organized by Shaq. I am the US once again. Just remind brashes of the 60-minute clock. So, looks like I set up Marshall Plan. Which is achingly transparent. But there's no point in headlining containment with three of the four op cards, which is an embarrassment of riches. So, that set up, and then headline Marshall Plan. Which is a monster giveaway, but that is life. I still don't know how I feel about it, really. But I do it. There's really no other sensible headline in there. I'm not headlining NORAD, and I'm not not headlining containment with so many 4-op cards. The risk is that I get purged, obviously, and De Gaulle and Suez obviously are a bit of a gimme. So Marshall's gone. He headlines Asia scoring. That's not a bad result for me. One in Turkey for access, and one in Greece to stop him getting to it first if we can. Asia's scoring goes. I suspect he'll take the coup of Iran, because it's cheaper. Obviously, at the moment, D-Style is my only blockade card, so I may want to try and hold containment for as long as possible, too. We'll see what comes first. I'm holding the mic as close to my mouth as possible because this headset's rubbish when it's earphones in. But apologies if it's still rubbish. The USB headset was even worse. So hopefully this is louder than it has been in the past, whilst not being terrible. Warsaw to Iran. Good coup. So I will counter coup with NATO. And he'll get the final coup if I don't do terribly. I do great, so he will want to counter coup that again. Now I suspect he doesn't have purge, because with the Marshall Plan setup he would have hit there first. So I suspect, unless he's also got nuclear test ban, he either has to choose to coup with the China card, which seems like rather a gambit. Or he may try and coup Panama, I suppose, but he might be worried about the CIA. So he may play into Afghanistan and try and seek a sneaky realignment. I, of course, want to push into Malaysia now. Despite Asia scoring having gone, I'm likely to be playing Vietnam Revolts at the end of the turn. To blunt its damage. So I'll pop an extra one in France against De Gaulle and Suez. If he's going to coup here, he probably wants Panama. But I suspect he'll put two in Afghanistan. Alright, goes Iraq, of course, to balance up. So let's cause him grief by popping one into Iraq and also push into Thailand. Give him some forking decisions. I mean, if he's got decoy, he's playing it, so it's not much of a forking decision. But I just need to overprotect Thailand before it comes to that. Let's threaten domination. Which gives them a cheaper call in Egypt, but I was going to be eventing Nasser anyway. This could, of course, backfire, but we'll give it a try. If he doesn't coup, I of course, in theory, have an option to realign Iraq. Alright, so he's going big with the China card. He wants Egypt. All he does is clear me out. Okay, I am going to play containment, and if he blockades me, he squeezes D-Style out. In which case, bully for him. Feedback always welcome. I made plenty of errors in the game against Doomsday. Sat through and watched it on his Twitch feed with him and had a chat. And then a helpful commenter picked up another couple of errors that I made along the way as well. So, plenty for me to be doing. Okay, so he gives up Middle East scoring, which I get for domination, which makes me look smarter than I really am. We'll event Nasser, and I'll push one into... What am I going to do? I'll pop another one in... I'll put it in France. Hello. Overprotect against De Gaulle because Europe's going to the last to come out. He gets to space first. And I will event Vietnam revolts and overprotect Thailand. So I get to hold D-Style. Defectus hasn't been yet. So that's good to try and stop him purging me, although I don't hold either. So duck and cover seems like the obvious play. I've got the China card, so I can hold D-Style through as long as I don't get purged. So duck and cover looks like the obvious headline here. Leaves me very ops light for the turn. But there's no other obvious headline. It's got to be duck and cover. Fine. So if I can blockade socialist governments, I can give the China card back and keep D-Style through to turn three. If I get purged, I have to space socialist governments and play all the other cards. Okay, so he goes Korean War. Does he win? Yes, he does. So he'll be taking that because he's dropped DEFCON. So I'm going to want to push into Pakistan fairly quickly. But we've decided we're playing the China card, so as long as he doesn't use a 4-op card and take Afghanistan, I can protect against the 1 in 6. So sensible play, if he's got nuclear test ban or purge here, is to take South Korea and Afghanistan. He may be able to 5-year plan Europe scoring as well, because we've not seen either of those go. But at the moment, with Iran as strong as it is, shoring up Asia for the next turn is a decent shout. He may want to play CIA before decol if he's got both. Because at the moment he's currently clear and I can't make him get influence there with no Fidel. So he might get a good opportunity to toss CIA. So I think he's 5-year planning Europe from the look of things. do that. Now, if he's got Indo-Pakistani war, he's certainly going to try the 1-6. It's a lot better than doing something else with the card, although he might want to take some more battlegrounds in the Middle East. I should be pushing into Saudi, I guess. If you take Libya and Egypt, I take Lebanon with blockade, if I get there first. I know, he took smart. But I'll challenge Egypt with Nasser Gom. Yeah, I strongly expect to see a 5-year plan ditch of Europe scoring. Balance of probability suggests he's got at least one of those two. Okay, so he's pushing to Saudi. Now I can take Israel with Arab-Israeli war and protect against the war triggering, because it's the one war card which benefits claiming control of the country itself. And he's already got his milops for the turn, so it doesn't matter that it's 4 or 2. Okay, so he probably doesn't have 5-year plan in Europe scoring this turn. He may do, actually. I was expecting him to UNI something. So, I take Israel with Arab-Israeli war. It triggers, but can't flip. And I'll be blockading socialist governments, put one more in France, just to basically prevent De Gaulle. Well, I mean, De Gaulle's already been gone as well, so. Let's just see if he 5-year plans Europe or not. If he does, then we can decide whether or not to do something more fancy in Asia. I expect to see a coup of Egypt next turn. Seems to be the obvious place on the board. He doesn't bother. That's good for me. Moves into overprotecting. I'll blockade SOCGOV. Let's blockade Dom. And I will pop the extra one into Egypt just to dissuade the coup even more. And I could even use Truman to put one in Panama to make it harder to flip. So I expect to see 5-year plan Europe here. Or decall, but he's or CIA to get it out of the deck. Well, it's not 5-year plan of Europe. If he's spending this long thinking about it. He would have just triggered it and then thought about where to put stuff. If he pushes into Afghanistan, I've got to pop one in Pakistan. Hope he doesn't redraw Indo-Pakistani war. if NATO doesn't trigger early on, I need to shore up Italy against brush war as well. So that means one more in Greece and one in Portugal. So yeah, next week I've got Shaq himself, the winner of last year's league. Being drawn in the Premier League was an honour and a nightmare. So we'll see whether it turns out to be more honourable or more nightmarish. Oh, here it is. So he pumps Afghanistan and ditches Europe scoring. Very nice. So one into Pakistan to protect against the China card, and then we just have to hope for the best on the reed shuffle. I get CIA, unfortunately. He knows I've got defectors, so he may get fancy. On the other hand, I know he has purge, so it's kind of mutually assured destruction. So let's mark his cards. He got nuclear test ban. He got purge. He did get decol. He got Olympic Games. And that's everything. So we know I'm holding defectors. D-Style. Eastern European unrest. He's also holding Suez Crisis. And he knows I got CIA, so he'll be happy to know that's not coming back till late war. So, he knows I've got defectors, and he knows I know he has purge. But there's no better card if Europe scoring's come out again and he's done it, then well played him. But I can't bank on that in the reshuffle. So defector seems like the logical headline. Okay, and I end up defecting Suez, which is nice. So I expect to see a nuclear test ban coup on Panama or Egypt. Panama's the softer target. Egypt will be the target if he is holding Middle East scoring. But obviously Sadat may come to my rescue in the long run. But with nuclear test ban, he may fancy his chances on Egypt. I, of course, want to shore up Afghanistan, ideally. And I also, if he does coup, want to put some influence into Angola before D-Star, D-Col comes out. So here comes the coup. It's on Panama, that's the obvious option. So, I will be putting one into Angola against Decol, and one into Algeria, two into Afghanistan. If he triggers it, I need to remember to put one in Thailand. But I expect to see him trigger Decol pretty quickly to take Nigeria and Zaire. I can at least do an intervention D-style. But there's really no point in me spacing this turn because he's already got his mil ops. So I expect D-Col to come out now. Good a time as any. Here it comes. One in Burma would be sensible too, to threaten India. Oh no, okay, fair enough. And he didn't put one in South Africa either, which is good for me. So, shore up and take Algeria, because he didn't push into Burma. That looks fine. He's got Red Scare Purge, so he may try flipping Angola, I guess. Is it better? So, one in Thailand, one in Angola, one in Algeria. What other three op cards does he have? He's got Olympic Games, Red Scare, so yes, he's Red Scare. I don't know he's holding any of the three op cards. So let's do that to avoid Angola flipping. we know he's got Olympic Games, Red Scare, and that's it. Now he's played all his other cards. So if he uses Red Scare to take Algeria, I mean, that's fine for a 4-up, really. I want to push into Burma and take India to make sure I'm 3-all, because obviously with US-Japan gone till late war, or till turn 7 reshuffle, he could actually use the China card or a bunch of ops to take Japan for adjacency. So I need to prepare for 3-3. Although then, of course, there's an incentive to take Taiwan just in case I can Formosa it. Above all else, the bonus, of course, right now is that... we're balanced in the Middle East, I'm ahead in Europe. Central America's risky, obviously, with Liberation Theology still to come out. And I do indeed need to remember to shore up Italy against Brush War. Because at the moment, that's a 50-50 target and a massive swing in Europe. So I mustn't get bogged down too quickly elsewhere. But let's see what his next card is. If he's going op heavy, he'll use Red Scare Purge to pump somewhere. Okay, I can live with that. So, let's put one in Greece, begin preparing for Brush War. That's no good, of course. I'm sure by the time Arab Israel comes back, Cam David will have popped in. So we know he's got OG. He may take Malaysia in a bid to make Thailand a 50-50 brush war. Okay, great. I get to score Europe. Lucky that came back in the reshuffle. Pressure up in Asia then. Okay. So he's already pushing for Central America big style. I can live with that for now. One into Malaysia. I'm going to finish with three into India to make Asia domination a problem for him. And put CIA back in the deck. So Italy and Thailand are both 1-in-3 brush wars, which make Angola the most attractive flip, but you know, it's a strong coup. Egypt's less attractive because of Sadat. And I will soon have to do something about Central America. Right, so we don't know what he's holding anymore. He's used all his cards. So I just need to get to Mexico before Liberation Theology. So, one small step's attractive if he races ahead. We will bury you to drop DEFCON. Although it gives away 3 VP. Missile MV is a DEFCON risk if he headlines Cuban Missile Crisis and I pull, duck, and cover. OPEC's currently worth 3, which makes it not very attractive, but I look like I'm spacing Quagmire, so I may be holding OPEC through to the next turn. NATO's not in force, so special relationship is no good. I'm attracted by headlining We Will Bury You to deny the coup. And then if he doesn't pull Liberation Theology, I can coup Mexico. Take Mexico. Let's do that. Okay, so he gets Brezhnev for a lot of ops this turn. So if he doesn't headline liberation theology too into Mexico. I usually eat flower power. I don't want to be using Indo-Pakistani war anyway. Arab-Israeli war's gone. It does make brush war less attractive. But if I'm spacing Quagmire, I've only then got 2, 4, 6, 8 usable ops if I don't use flower power. I can always use OPEC to pop Libya and then play an influence somewhere else, but then I'm trading 2 VP for 1 op, which is not very efficient. So that's unattractive. So if he doesn't headline, or if he doesn't play liberation theology, I'll pop 2 in Mexico. Already holding Egypt, actually, it might be worth just playing Camp David for the ops. It's not coming back till turn 7 anywhere, and I have it controlled. Although, Muslim Revolution, of course, turns Egypt red again. Muslim Rev's a pretty big threat, because obviously Egypt and Iran are the two obvious choices. And although I can play back into Iran, I can't play back into Egypt. So once again, he's not using Indo-Pakistan war. That looks like a fairly obvious Africa domination attempt. I'm going to use flower power to coup. I'm going to hope to clean him out and put up a realign risk. I do not manage to achieve the realign risk. So he may just pop a 3 op straight back in Tunisia. It wouldn't be a terrible riposte, really. I don't have another big coup card. So I likely eat it and pop 2 in Mexico, and then hopefully try and set up a realign on Cuba. Or do I do it the other way around? Because I'm sure he would have played liberation theology by now. Okay, so he's given me John Paul. And he's going. So I'm going to give up on Africa and have a 2-op pop on Cuba. Not spectacular. He'll ditch Africa scoring if he's got it. There it is. I'm going to have another crack at Cuba. There it is. Lucky, lucky, lucky. Not lucky. Okay, that's fine. He may still have a pop at Tunisia for his mill ops. I need space Quagmire. Oh, blimey, he does have it. Well, that took me by surprise. So yet another realign on Cuba. There it is. Now a lucky one on Mexico, I hope. No. I mean, that indicates he doesn't hold Central America scoring, at least. Alright, well, space Quagmire. Hoping that he responds with space. It doesn't matter anyway. I say that, actually. I can invent one small step. Which would then trigger being able to space another card this turn. Which, while it doesn't set up an AR7 crisis, does help with the fact I've got kind of crummy enemy 3-op cards. He's had every scoring card so far, that is bad luck. He's managed to play one for serious benefit and one for very slight benefit. But obviously it jams up his hand, and he's given me two for domination. And could have given me a third if not for 5-year plan. Okay, so I'm going to give him 3 VP for OPEC and put 3 in Cuba. I know that sets me up for Ortega later, but I don't want to be presenceless in Central America. So that was worth 7 versus, well, probably at 4 here. Yeah, 4 plus 3 equals, what's presenceless domination? 3, 4, 5, 6. Actually, maybe it's a bad swing by me, actually. Unless I can realign Mexico, obviously. And he spaces colonial rear guards. He succeeds. So I may keep one small step and try and leapfrog him. So I'm going to event socialist governments. See what damage he does and repair. Now if he's got sense, I would say 2 from West Germany, 1 from Greece. Because that softens up the brush war target. And means I actually have to put all 3 ops back in. If he takes 1 out of France, or 1 out of the UK, or even 1 out of Italy, it's less of a concern. So 2 West Germany, 1 Greece is what I would do. Very nice. Okay, I'm forced to respond. So what do we have? I have lone gunman. Would have been nice to have Cuba Missile Crisis as well. Amit seems to be a fairly good headline here. In the absence of anything else. So I didn't get ABM, Brush, Salt, or Junta. Bummer. So we'll headline Amit and see what comes out. So I'll be spacing Muslim Rev and hoping to then once more step it. So let's ditch Arms Race, which is pro USSR. And to balance the game, let's ditch Salt and keep the rest. We definitely want C, Nixon, and Shuttle in the deck. Okay, so if he puts two in South Africa and Coos, Angola, that's kind of gross, but can't really be helped. I'll be triggering Warsaw Pact, and he would do well, actually, just to kick me out of Poland. But he goes 2-2 in the coup, okay. So, I'm not a big fan of that, because he could have just realigned me. So now the natural reaction is 3 into South Africa to make sure it's not all doom and gloom. He does get Central America, well done him. He's starting to rack up a nice score. Well, space Muslim Rev. Ye gods. I mean, I can't hold one small step now. So if he spaces and fails, I event one small step to deny him a second space. He ditches South America at nothing. Trigger Willy Brand. Repair. And pop one in there for Southeast Asia scoring. So hopefully it's a point for a point. Well, I'm asking for Asia and Southeast Asia to come to my rescue here. To that end, it's becoming a question. I probably should pop one in Japan to deny the China card taking outright, but maybe just the one. He spaces Puppet if he fails. He succeeds, so it becomes a question of whether it's worth me using one small step. I'm so far behind now. To some extent, I need to try and keep up. I am going to keep up in the space race, foregoing a victory point in doing so. Let me know if you think that's stupid and I'm fighting for no good reason. I'm going to also need to coup at some point, or he's going to be up to 17 points before I know it. I really need Asia and Southeast Asia scoring to come out next turn, or I'm starting to get really close to the wire. His clock management is very good. He's about half the clock for half the game. Let me know if you think I'm racing. He's trapping himself. I can but hope. Not that I can do a lot with it. So if I coup Saharan States and succeed, that's a start. I can then flip Nigeria with Warsaw Pact, and then coup Sudan with Summit to get my mill ops for the turn. And what I'd love is for him to fail here, but I expect grain sales. Oh, containment, okay. Straight out the trap. Well done, him. So if it were me, I'd be booting me out of Poland. Whoa, sorry, not used to the laptop. I would boot me out of Poland rather than adding influence elsewhere. I know Solidarity will still come, but 3-4 is better than 4-4. Although you may think, oh, I'll just pump to level up country count, because he can take Czechoslovakia and Yugoslavia, but Independent Reds is still to come out, and Truman hasn't been activated, so we'll see what he does. Oh yeah, of course. That also works. Oh boy. Power cards. Obviously. I'm going to be fighting that anytime soon. So I'll Coup Sudan for my last mill op. And I'm very close to being mullered. Asia scoring is good. Grain sales is handy. So the question is, do I headline duck and cover for the points, knowing that we will bury you's gone? Or do I grain sales in? Because I may pull Junta, amongst other things. He at least doesn't have a card that gets him 5 points outright. He may try bush roaring Thailand or Pakistan. Grain sales or duck and cover? Let's go grain sales. I know I'm close to the war on points, but hand shortening's always fun. And he's not peaking yet. Okay, so he's getting his mill ops. Saharan States is the only target. Oh no, Tunisia is as well, of course. And he cleans me out. Nicely done. I will coup with it. I will coup Mexico. And I will do poorly with it. So getting Asia scoring is a priority, and holding Allende and Lone Gunman is probably. So if I were him, knowing Asia scoring is coming out this turn or next, pumping the China card into Japan, knowing US Japan's in the deck, is not a bad move. To which I event shuttle diplomacy, of course. So there is that. It's going, lads. Fine. Let's play Asia scoring and get the scoreline down a little. So we've still got Southeast Asia scoring to come out. He continues to relentlessly march along the spaceboard, and he is now peaking, which makes me play suboptimally. I'll coup on Guatemala in the hopes of a nice big coup, not very big. to try and get a double realign on Mexico. I've got two decent coup cards left, but I need to OAS into Chile and Venezuela, maybe? Junta's problematic. He's now unable to space two op cards, though. So things like VOA become a problem for him. One point for that, nicely disposed of. And he gets the coup target. But we'll keep couping Guatemala. I'm not doing a lot else around the board. There we go. That might be a problem for him. So I'll pop that into Romania and hope for Truman later on. So he may come Guatemala here. No. Okay, so he threatens his own realign, which I can't do a lot about, in my opinion, because Botswana is that much more stable. So we're going to go for the rear line and try and take domination in Central America off him. And I can't realign for Toffee today. Okay, it's a start. So he may do his own realigning in South Africa, or he may shore up Mexico. If he shores up Mexico, I guess I'll have another stab with Portuguese Empire. So turn 7 will be a race to see who gets Junta. Junta's going to be a massive turn 7 card. Yeah, so he takes his chances. He'll need 4. He gets them. Do I play back in? Yeah, I think I play back in with Angola next door. And I'm going to have to play Allende. So trigger OS founded and try and realign Allende next to Argentina? Guess so. That'll at least force him to realign again. Well, Africa's looking like a 10-point mess. The trade-offs are Europe and Asia. The Middle East is precarious. And South America's, yeah, I mean, it's about to get settled in a way. Takes China back. Let's event OAS. 2 in Argentina, prepare for realign. Well, realign. Actually, I can put 2 in Allende, trigger Allende and put the 1 in Chile, so if he coups Argentina, I don't lose all my presence. But it really does boil down to who gets Junta, doesn't it? Crazy. Perfect. Even better. Yeah, so that's not good. One in Chile with Truman. So now it becomes the old reshuffle game. Will Africa scoring come out quickly or slowly? We'll start by purging him. I got CIA back, which is annoying. But I've got NATO as well, so we'll definitely purge him. He's got Brush War and Junta, which is a delight. Let's do that first. He's definitely got Junta at Brush War and Southeast Asia scoring. I've got nuclear subs. He's got Junta. That's a serious bummer. He knows I've got VOA though. He's got Panama Canal returned, which is good for me. I've got Nixon and Sadat. And I've got VOA. So we know he's got Panama, Junta, Southeast Asia going in brush war. He may brush on Italy or Thailand. He may brush on Argentina. But I suspect Junta might come first. He knows what my headline's going to be. So there's no point in me playing CIA. The biggest swing is Europe with brush war. But that doesn't merit headlining NATO, really. The other option is nuclear subs. Try and clean up Africa a wee bit. Because I've got CIA. Is nuclear subs more attractive? So the benefits to nuclear subs, yeah, I can be coup happy, can't I, even if he juntas. And then I keep 2 4-up cards in my hand. So let's do that. Let's see how badly this backfires. Let me know if you think purge was a more obvious solution. Of course, if he has a bad first coup, I can still purge him. But it's a waste of an AR, really. At the very least, I can... Okay, good. C5 doesn't get him anywhere. So let's see what he does. Keeping DEFCON high and putting one in Cameroon and one in Zimbabwe is not a bad start. That's a terrible coup for him, unfortunately. And let's see if I can get some benefit from NORAD in the late game. He's still got Junta, and I know he's got Junta, and he knows I know he has Junta, yada yada yada. So now's the time for VOA. So the only question is, where else? ideally access. So, one. And one to cause him trouble elsewhere. At least takes away the idea of him doing anything crazy, but Brush War might come out now for Thailand. Because that does Southeast Asia and Asia. I may use Nixon to take the China card off him. I definitely want a coup on Zaire. Which he may brush war straight back, of course, which is the risk. Oh boy, that's a good turn 7 pull. So the coup on Venezuela comes first. And it's crap. Now I'm in serious trouble. I'm basically giving up South America here. So, it did kind of come down to Argentina, but not in the way you expected. I'm going to take the China card off him. Because grain sales is a DEFCON suicide card. And this might now be the only way I can win. Straight back into Venezuela. What does a one-op coup do on here? Nothing half the time. Cleans him out some of the time. So let's coup Zaire. Potential brush war straight back, but it's a bit of a waste of brush war. Still holding brush in Southeast Asia, so it's only a question what his last card is. Here we go. He fails on Italy, just by the skin of my teeth. I'm going to pop one at a time in Chile, in a bid to try and save face. So now it becomes scoring card timing. If Central America, Asia, and Europe come out before, if he's got a 5-year plan, that'd be a delight, wouldn't it? Yeah, if my scoring cards come out before his scoring cards, I stand a chance. If Africa and South America come out and or war games, the jig is up. And that is how late war is. He does. Well done him. That's an 11-point swing. There's really nothing I can do about that. Well, duck and cover's unplayable if he picks up... Cal. So, Ottoman Empire is the polite headline. And if he drops DEFCON in the headline, then the game's over. Well, I was lucky not to get brushed on Italy. But being able to 5-year plan two scoring cards for an 11-point swing, if I was USA 3 here, I'd be a lot less sweaty. But I'm below the DEFCON threshold. Africa is a complete nightmare. South America's not much better. My light is looking dim. Of course, he can't headline Cal to drop DEFCON in the headline. But he can with Lone Gunman. So that may be the game. Although if he's got this much to think about, he may not hold him, because he should be cooing Zaire and playing war games if he's got it. Going for the rear line instead. Interesting. Now the coup of Zaire. Ah, no, he's asking for... Why give him arms race? Because it triggers and he doesn't... That's weird. Yeah. Okay, I give him arms race, nothing happens. Is that not a gaffe? Ah. I see. I can't take the coup in case he has war games. I know... he would have cooed with... Unless this is... If this is an epic double bluff, if this is a double bluff, then absolutely hats off to him. Because I don't know why you would trade a chance at winning outright by cooing and then playing war games. So, yeah. What's happened? Oh, yeah. See, it reset because I undid. Yeah. Can't for the life of me think what else he's doing. So I'm going to coup Venezuela. And if he's got war games, chapeau. Indeed it is not. I can only assume that was an error, and I can now only hope to capitalize from that error. We can do some back and forth. Ops warring. So there's still breath in me. Not a lot. And knowing Southeast Asia scoring is not going to come out galling. See where those went. South Africa, fine. So. Cause him some heartache in South America, but not for very long. No, not both of them. One in Brazil, one in Colombia. And I just keep tapping Brazil. I mean, you see my hand. He knows I don't have diddly. But I don't mind some cooing and counter-cooing on Colombia. Where did the other one go? So he's setting up a 2-1 realign. Let's coup Cameroon. Now he'll coup Colombia. And let's just hope it's not a 5. Here it comes. It's pretty big. That's quite big. Dreams were not big enough. So he'll set up the realign. If he succeeds, he'll try and realign me out of Brazil. Because I could just pop 2 back in Venezuela. Touch of a betrayer. Lucky start. Lucky. Lucky, lucky, lucky. Fine. Then goes Chernobyl. So we'll break control of Zaire, which is worth a few points. So we're below the wargames threshold. I still don't hold it. Sorting ABM might be an option. Sorting VOA, more attractive. Do we start with colonial rear guards? He still retains domination. So we'll headline ABM. we'll see what he riposts. Sorting VOA or ducking cover is relatively attractive for score threshold management. So sorting VOA for the end game, if there is an end game, is always attractive. Let's see what he gets up to. Worth 6 if I hold Zaire, so he'll go up to 12. So if he's got war games, I can't keep DEFCON raising again and again and again, I guess. There'll come a point where he manages to get it down. So if I sort ABM back, it's just a matter of delaying the inevitable. Okay. So, let's pop 1 into France to protect against De Gaulle. We'll just jam the other two in Zaire, make the coup harder. Aldridging Allende looks good at the end. The major issue is Africa, which I can do very little about. Colonial rear guards can frig with it for a while, but not a great deal because he's overprotected Algeria, which is good. Okay, so he boots me out of the Middle East, which is a solid option. Of course, Arab-Israeli war is now a hotter property because of the taking of Egypt. What puppet governments do? Not a lot. Overprotect Venezuela, because I expect the Iran hostage crisis come out not long after this. So he gets Middle East domination back, unless I can crack off a coup on Egypt. That may be a reason to return the China card. Okay, so he gets his coup off with terrorism. He doesn't do very well. So I will use the China card, and I will coup Egypt. And it's complete crap. So, if he now scores Africa or Middle East, I'll be salting to keep DEFCON up. But I'll need to use VOA immediately because of Aldrich Ames. Gets South America off even. So I'll pop two in Egypt and try and level up quickly. Because it doesn't suggest that he's... strong for it. I mean, he's been unlucky not to draw war games. He's been in and around the threshold the whole time. Good for him. That's lucky for me. So I guess I play Colonial Reagan and I end a and hold Sultan Aldrich. Okay. I'll take the coup on Colombia. It wasn't great. So he's got 8 to my 3, and there aren't enough one stab. I get an extra point in Romania at least. That's not good. Oh. Break was one, all right. So, bump. 1, 2, 3, 4. Start to... I thought I want to break South Africa, don't I? All the non battlegrounds. 1, 2, 3, 4. Make his life slightly difficult there. Or they may just choose to realign willy nilly. I may sort VOA AR7 here. Keep Aldrich and Iende for turn 10. So if I'm lucky, Asia may still come out. Okay, so... entertainment. What's it worth? Not as much as sorting VOA and getting it in my hand. So I didn't get War Games. Middle East is currently zero. And I got a really red. I mean, I can Aldridge Middle East scoring, can't I? Which means I have to play VOA sooner. So VOA in the headline. Get it done. Depending on what he headlines. May dictate where I go. I'm just trying to telegraph a couple of regions that I was behind in or ahead of, so I just want to try and make him uncomfortable, really. But I expect to impel these into Africa. So there'll be a 6-point swing if he takes Africa scoring and I take Middle Eastern scoring, which will put him over the War Games limit. Whoa, apologies. He may go Laos, Cambodia and Malaysia if he's got Brush War to try and take Thailand to the 2/3. I expect to see a coup of Africa first. Which he does. So let's take Middle Eastern scoring. Before anything. If he takes Africa scoring, I can then use Summit at 4-1. To drop DEFCON and take some points, possibly. Big coup of China coming on Thailand. Oh no, on Pakistan. It's huge. Don't need to do that yet. Should we do Summit at 3-1? Why not? Let's gamble. Everyone likes to gamble. And the USSR wins. Fabulous. Fabulous. That may have been silly. Because he can raise DEFCON and Coup Asia again if he wants. Well, if I'd have been 5 up at DEFCON 2, the game would have looked different. Now it's wide open again. Where is an op best spent? Put one into Japan. Here comes Venezuela. That'll force him to put one in North Korea. He did have war games, but couldn't use it. So his space liberation theory. Coup with South African unrest. And AR-7 Aldrich aims, hoping for enough to stay ahead. And I have 20 minutes to do my math. Enjoy. Unlucky there. That's probably a big swing. If that does go down. Straight back in to avoid domination. Here's AR-7. At the moment, he's winning because Africa and South America beat Europe, Central America, and the point in Asia. taking a wee while, because obviously Crane Sales is the only really bad card for him. And he's got three cards left in his hand. Well, Grain Sales and Cal. If he's got those two, he has to play whatever last card is in his hand. But he's probably just sizing up where he can do the most damage for me to have to respond. In Taiwan. Well, now it's time to do the maths, because if I take Taiwan, how does it look? He's now scoring 17 to my 3, 9. So 6 in Asia. Yeah, 6, 12, 15. So I get 15. This is going to be a tie because I've got the China card, isn't it? So he gets 17. Africa and South America, 17. Which puts me on minus 16, minus 15 holding the China card, and then I get 15, Central America, Europe, Asia. Well, look, I've got 19 minutes left on my clock, so I'm going to do it again. He gets 10 for Africa. And 7 for South America. 17 puts me on minus 16. Minus 15 with the China card. Minus 12. Minus 6. And 6 in Asia for 0. Okay, so that's a tie. What if I do that? It's 4 in South America. I'm just pressing undo because the last thing I need to do is frig it up. And 1 in the Middle East. So he gets 14. But I don't get Asia for 1. And, because of play deck, I think the win goes to America. Let's find out. Because I definitely can't do better. Thank you for waiting 5 minutes while I did the maths. Well, that's sheerly ridiculous, but at least I will not go all losses in this league. Thanks for watching. Tell me if you thought you could save a VP somewhere, because it really is that fine a margin. And I will see you next week when we play Shaq. Alright, anyway, thanks for watching. I'm gonna click off. Have fun talking and tell me where VPs could have been shaved off for one of us to claim it. And I'll claim the Playdeck win because of their silly buggy workings. Thanks for